The oceans cover over 70% of the Earth's surface and play a central role in regulating the planet's climate. However, have you ever wondered what would happen if the oceans disappeared? While it is a completely hypothetical scenario, it is worth exploring the potential consequences of such an event. If you like this kind of scenarios, you can subscribe to my channel. Also, if you have similar ideas, write in the comments section and I will make a video of it. So let's dive into this thought experiment. If the oceans were to disappear, the impact on the global climate would be unimaginable. The oceans absorb heat from the sun and distribute it around the world, helping to regulate temperatures and weather patterns. Without this vital mechanism, the Earth's climate would become much more extreme, with temperatures fluctuating wildly and weather patterns becoming completely unpredictable. This would have a significant impact on almost everything on Earth. The disappearance of the oceans would have a huge impact on the global climate, leading to extreme temperatures and unpredictable weather patterns. The ecological consequences of the oceans disappearing would be catastrophic, with marine life dying off and ecosystems collapsing. Without oceans, it is probable that all life on Earth would be lost. The planet itself would change significantly with shifts in land masses and potential for loss of all, even fresh water on Earth. Oceans dried up, what now? To comprehend the enormity of Earth's oceans, consider that they contain approximately 97% of the planet's water. The remaining 3% is fresh water, with the majority locked in glaciers and ice caps. Additionally, the world's oceans cover a total surface area of approximately 361 million square kilometers, or 139 million square miles. Moreover, oceans are home to 243,613 known marine species, with thousands, if not millions, more yet to be discovered. We're providing all of this data so that you can picture how catastrophic it would be if oceans disappeared. Here we'll try to summarize consequences in a few paragraphs, and then we'll deep dive into each of the categories. Firstly, the absence of oceans would have a major impact on the climate. Secondly, the disappearance of oceans would have a significant impact on the food chain and all ecosystems on Earth. Thirdly, the absence of oceans would have a major impact on all life on Earth. And finally, Earth without the oceans would be a completely different planet itself. So, it is rather clear that the disappearance of oceans would have a catastrophic impact on the planet. But let's explore this huge impact in more details. Fewer volcanoes, more mountains. Maybe shockingly, the volcanic activity would diminish even with a water shortage. Supervolcanoes and their eruptions are brought about by tectonic plates crashing into one another and running more than each other, which is often brought about by the heaviness of seas pushing one plate underneath another. Additionally, when the volcano has been shaped, water likewise assumes a necessary part in its instability. At high temperatures and high tensions, the liquid inside the Earth's crust becomes magma, bringing about emissions like the one at Vesuvius, which was accomplished for helpless old Pompeii. In this way, with no sea to burden plates and no water to control eruptions, the world is left with a progression of extraordinarily high mountain edges anytime two tectonic plates are impacted. Such an interaction would require centuries to happen. However, the outcome would be a desert-like, infertile world populated by spiky edges and gulfing channels. Global climate impact. The disappearance of oceans would cause significant atmospheric changes. Ocean plays a vital role in regulating the Earth's climate by absorbing carbon dioxide and releasing oxygen. Without oceans, the carbon dioxide levels in the atmosphere would increase, leading to an enhanced greenhouse effect. This would result in a rise in global temperatures and could trigger a chain reaction of catastrophic events. Temperature extremes. The disappearance of oceans would cause significant temperature extremes on Earth. The ocean acts as a heat sink, absorbing and releasing heat, which helps regulate the Earth's temperature. Without the ocean, the temperature of the planet would become more extreme, with hotter and colder regions. The polar regions would experience more significant temperature rises, leading to the melting of ice caps and rising sea levels. Weather and rain without oceans. The disappearance of oceans would also alter weather patterns across the globe. The ocean's currents and temperatures play a crucial role in driving weather patterns and climate cycles. Without the ocean, the world would experience more frequent and severe weather events, such as hurricanes, typhoons, and cyclones. Additionally, if oceans were to disappear, the world would lose a significant source of water. Namely, oceans contribute to the water cycle by evaporating water into the atmosphere, which later falls as rain. The absence of this cycle would disrupt weather patterns and drastically reduce the planet's overall water supply. And so, in that case, we must ask ourselves this question. How much water would be left? Well, without oceans, Earth's surface would be left with only the fresh water available in lakes, rivers, and underground reservoirs. By the way, have in mind that in the absence of oceans, even the fresh water would probably diminish significantly, if not completely, over time. As mentioned previously, oceans contain approximately 96 to 97% of the Earth's total water, leaving a mere 3% as fresh water. The loss of oceans would result in an extremely large reduction in the available water, leading to severe water scarcity and threatening the survival of numerous species, including humans. To put this into perspective, consider that the volume of Earth's oceans is estimated to be around 1,332 billion cubic kilometers. If we were to distribute this water evenly across the Earth's landmass, the entire planet would be submerged under an ocean approximately 2.7 kilometers deep. So, if there were no oceans, this is what we would have. Now, isn't this astonishing? Especially when you consider how big some lakes are, like Lake Superior or Lake Michigan. And yet, all lakes combined contain only about 0.01% of Earth's water. And did you know how many lakes are there? It's an astonishing number. It is estimated there are over 304 million lakes in the world. And all that water is minuscule compared to oceans. Therefore, without oceans, probably there wouldn't be any life on Earth. So let's hypothesize about the potential for human survival on Earth without oceans and the survival of any life on Earth without oceans. So worse than the Ice Age? Humans might survive for a while near our homes. We would still have access to groundwater and might get some underground hydroponic farms working. But on the surface, plants and animals would begin to die out immediately. While trees can survive for a while without water, eventually everything would become so dry that fires would span the continents. This would be a multifaceted problem for humans. Aside from the usual problems associated with fire, such as burning to death, the blazes would release tons of carbon dioxide into the progressively stifling atmosphere, accelerating global warming. For humankind, the situation would be more inhospitable than the Ice Age. The sun would continue to pound the equator, turning it into a furnace with no relief from circulating ocean currents. Meanwhile, greenhouse gases from the world's fires would trap the sun's energy close to the ground. Some difference in temperature between night and day would create high and low pressure systems and produce wind. But the average temperature on Earth would be 153 degrees Fahrenheit, making surface life impossible for even the hardiest desert animals. Last stop, Antarctica? People would have to move. Humanity's only hope would be the window when the Antarctic ice sheet was still intact, prompting massive migrations to the southern hemisphere. As temperatures across the globe rose and Earth's surface became uninhabitable, all of our energy would go toward collecting Antarctic ice underground, where it would be safe from evaporation. We might try to build some kind of self-sustaining biosphere underground, but Antarctica's remoteness would make it difficult. Just getting there would be hard enough given the unpredictable sea level, and survivors would find a flooded wasteland and no infrastructure or resources. No mines, no roads, no food. It's unlikely enough people would survive to finish the project. The few remaining stragglers would dwell in underground bunkers. Things would get worse. On the planet's surface, all plant life is gone. As the world burns, the atmosphere would become less and less oxygenated, perhaps becoming unbreathable for humans even if they could somehow tolerate the extreme surface temperatures. The land would fry. Assuming humans could survive much longer in our Antarctic bunkers, there would be no way to restart a healthy carbon cycle or bring temperatures back down to reasonable, livable levels. As humans ran out of the scant resources we'd packed along to Antarctica, we'd die off. Earth's only survivors would be small colonies of chemosynthetic bacteria hidden underground in hot springs. Would humanity survive without oceans? Let's just answer this straight away. Without oceans, humans probably would not survive. As mentioned, oceans play a crucial role in maintaining the planet's climate, and their absence would result in extreme and uninhabitable environmental conditions. One of the significant consequences would certainly be the scarcity of rain. Oceans contribute significantly to the moisture content in the atmosphere, influencing rainfall patterns. The absence of oceans would create a moisture deficit, particularly in coastal and inland areas, transforming once fertile lands into deserts. This scarcity of rain would exacerbate the challenges of food production and further strain water resources, which would all lead to slow but certain demise of humans. So this leads us to questioning overall life on Earth in the hypothetical scenario where oceans have dried up. Would life exist on Earth without oceans? Again, to answer this straight away, probably not. It would not happen immediately, but certainly over time. We have Mars as an example. Namely, evidence suggests that ancient Martian oceans existed billions of years ago. However, over time, Mars lost its magnetic field, and solar winds stripped away its atmosphere, causing the oceans to evaporate and leaving the planet deserted. Probably similar would happen to Earth over time. Oxygen and oceans. Besides that, oceans are major contributors to the production of oxygen on Earth. Phytoplankton, microscopic organisms found in the oceans, produce a significant portion of the world's oxygen through photosynthesis. The disappearance of oceans would result in a drastic reduction in oxygen production, jeopardizing the very air we breathe. Approximately 50-85% of the world's oxygen is produced by phytoplankton through photosynthesis.